So the first thing I thought of was your inspection report. I always thought your inspection report is the most important piece of marketing in your business because it provides all the information that a potential client needs in order to make a decision about hiring you. So after you read one of my home inspection reports, you basically know everything you need to be convinced to hire me. I mean, if I can't convince you to hire me after you read my inspection report, there's something wrong with my inspection report. My inspection report is better than a business card, a flyer, better than a website, almost better than me talking about me. So every day, you need to work on your home inspection report and your software. Clients nowadays expect a home inspector to use software. So you have to use software. And I've taught about how to use a mobile device. We've gone through classes about that, how it speeds up your inspections. And you can make more profit by reducing the amount of work that you do. But really, the end result is a beautifully produced, well-written inspection report, which is a marketing tool. So you may not be thinking about that. You may not be thinking that your report is a marketing tool, but it is. It's the thing that you produce that we can all judge you on. We can judge your book by your cover. Essentially, we can judge any home inspector by the report that he or she writes. So make sure it's a good one. So if you need to take a look at one of my reports that I wrote when I was a home inspector 10 years ago, I get this request all the time. So I put my inspection reports online and it's at step 7 at that URL. Let's go back to that URL, nachi.org/everything. If we go there, you get to this page called 15 Steps for Being a Successful Home Inspector. And you scroll down to step 11, and to see one of my inspection reports, it's a link there, sample inspection reports, and you go to NACHI TV, NACHI.TV, and you go to the home inspection tab. Let's see here, the home inspection tab at the top, and you click one of the classes, one of these recorded classes on how to perform a home inspection. And in that class, I go over a lot of slides, a lot of pictures, and also the sample report, the report itself that I wrote during that inspection, for that inspection. So you just click this inspection report. This is inspection report number 20. It's a PDF document. You can go over it. If you want to steal from it, go right ahead. You have my permission right here, right now. Permission to use anything you want. The format, the way I write, I wrote terribly. I wrote like I speak, and I speak in fraction sentences. So if you are robust and eloquent in your language, you should write your narratives, your report, just the way you speak. I wrote mine just the way I spoke. I thought that was appropriate. I really didn't like buying narratives that someone else wrote well, eloquently, in large paragraphs, using big words that I don't know. I wrote my own narratives. So if I had to describe something in my inspection report, it was basically me talking. And that worked well because that was part of my service. My brand was I spoke, I educated my clients while doing an inspection, and what I actually said appeared in my inspection report. It wasn't something different. I reduced my liability, legal liability, that way as well. So if you wanted to check out some sample reports to build your own or to judge mine against yours, my terrible reports against your really good reports, make sure yours is much better than mine. Okay, mine are really bad. We also have a report writing course, which is really good. The report writing course is basically, we give you a big bunch of pictures of defects, and you write how you would describe those defects. And we also provide you what other home inspectors wrote about those defects. So there's a defect there. It's an obvious defect, missing shingles, exposed underlayment, prone to active water leaks, major water leaks. There's even sheathing exposed. The underlayment is not there. Is that an underlayment? So how would you write that up? If you took that inspection picture, how would you write it? And that is an exercise that every home inspector should do, ideally prior to your first job. And if you're a veteran, let's say you are taking this class and you just want to boost your business a little bit with marketing, well, you should be writing your inspection report better than anybody else. Because you've had, let's say, 10 years upon everyone else in building the most important marketing piece that any home inspector could produce, which is your inspection report. So what I do during class is I ask my students to provide samples of their inspection reports, and I judge them upon their reports. That's how important it is. I can critique them on how well they perform a home inspection upon how well that report is written. It is the most important piece, I would say, of marketing that any home inspector could work on. So we provide you different kinds of tools in order to write a better report. One of them is this online class that you could take, free online report writing course for members of InterNACHI. We also have a checklist. This inspection report checklist is based upon the standards of practice. It's free, it's downloadable, anybody can go there. Take a look at how your report is structured in comparison to the InterNACHI sample checklist, because the InterNACHI sample checklist is based upon the standards of practice. How the standards of practice flow and what you're required to inspect and not required to inspect are reflected in the simple basic checklist, which should be a starting point for a very good home inspection report, which is your best marketing piece. See how it's interconnected. Your marketing piece is actually connected to the standards of practice.